If you were not faithful to Jesus, if you were not obedient to Jesus, do you think he's going to defend you? It's not. And I find the Bible declared, if you are ashamed of me, I will also be ashamed of you before my Father. Hallelujah. So which means that if you are rejecting Jesus today, if you are betraying Jesus today, and also remember, Jesus is the Word of God. Hallelujah. He is the Word of God. When you are negating the Word of God, you are negating Jesus Christ. When you are negating the Word of God, you are negating Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You are negating Him. When you're negating the Word of God, I want you also to know that the same Word of God you are negating, it's the same Word of God that will stand beside you, that defend you before God. Because none of us deserve to inherit the kingdom of God. Nobody deserves. If that person has been justified by Christ, he has been justified, redeemed by Christ himself. God, the man, whoever asking himself from people does not have wisdom, he's asking himself from the wisdom. You're asking yourself, people say, you know what? I just want to ask it myself, man. I want to just live it by myself. I'm just saying it from the problems. Whoever asks himself from everyone is running away from wisdom, from knowledge. So you're never going to learn. God has called us to be a party. He has called us to be together. Because the Bible declares, if one can do 100, two can do 1,000. Hallelujah. Impact is tremendous. We need one another. The more you neglect one another, the more you neglect the impact. We become so busy with our life to the point that we don't even have. We become deaf. We become so deaf to the voice of God. God speaks to us many times. He speaks to us many times. And I can tell you right now, if everybody, if each one of us in this church, we say, I want to do something. I want to do, regardless of what I want to do something for the church. Let me tell you something. We're going to see the church is going. You're going to see many things happening. Many things happening. We have to work for God. We have to work for God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We have to work for God. If your life is going to work for God, that means you are an active member of the body of Christ. The way you are an active member, you are.